You know, a big part of COTS was change management, and it was a very big break from our traditional spaceflight development programs. That takes some conscious thought. You need to really think about, hey, I'm doing something different here. And in order to get people to go along with that, there are definitely some techniques and some mechanisms that you can use that help with that whole change management function. And I think it's important to acknowledge that and to incorporate and leverage some of those mechanisms and techniques so that you make the change a little bit more amenable to both organizations. SpaceX, for example, didn't have a lot of history of working with the federal government in 2005. And so it was a change for them, as well it was as a change for us, right? So I think acknowledging that, there are lots of textbooks and lots of knowledge about how to achieve sort of a change management function. And I think those are all good and should be looked at and incorporated when you're trying to make a real break. It's not just enough to say, I think this can work and I think it can achieve some really good benefits either from a safety or a technical or a cost standpoint. You definitely need to acknowledge that this is gonna be hard for people, right? Doing this so differently and having our role be so different than our historical experience, it's not easy for people. And you can't expect people to just turn on a dime and say, okay, yeah, I'm going to do it differently this way. You need to sort of help bring them along. And you also need to make sure that you're not just paying lip service to the fact that you are going to do things differently. I've heard a lot of managers over time say, yeah, I'm open to new ideas. And different groups at NASA have said, yes, we're totally flexible. You can tailor this, or you can tailor that document, or you can tailor this approach, and we're going to be open to all that until you actually have to tailor it. And then suddenly things get really hard. They're like, oh, well, you can't do that, right? You can't change that. I wasn't talking about that. Well, you need to be able and open to changing these real important big things, or you're not going to achieve big gains or big differences, positive differences than your historical spaceflight experience. So you have to be open to change the big things as well as the little things. And I think when you're talking with groups that have been used to doing things a particular way and successful at it, I'm sure they will tell you that they're open and flexible. You're going to get that. But you need to make sure that they're open and flexible on the things you need them to be flexible on. And I found that was one of the harder things that we had to accomplish with COTS, and particularly then with crew. You'd get sort of pulled into this, oh, yeah, they're definitely going to be open and flexible to new ideas. And then when you get to it, you really come down to the hard, hard part of changing the way you're doing business. That's when people sort of retreat back to their comfort zone. And that's where it gets the most difficult, because you're not going to achieve great benefits unless, or you're not going to achieve big differences than your historical experience unless you're willing to change the big things, the things that maybe even you think are critical to success. If you're not open to different ways of doing about of going about doing that, you're not going to be successful in a partnership mode or any kind of different operating environment than your historical experience. I think that's one of the big pitfalls that we sometimes fall into. Again, I said this before, you think you're going to do things exactly the same way, it's just going to be cheaper. I can't tell you how many charts I've seen somebody throw up and say, yeah, we're going to do this commercially, and it's just a little bubble, without really thinking through what that means to really do that commercially. A lot of times we think we're just going to do that our traditional way, and it'll just be better because it will call it commercial. No, you really have to be able to change fundamentally how you're executing these things, or I think you're either not going to be successful or you're not going to achieve the benefits that you were hoping to at the beginning.